Angeles I'm gonna be for the next 3 weeks. We're going now. New York, Casablanca, Agadir. Gonna go to Morocco.
We have just landed at Agadir Mesira Airport. It's 11 a.m. local time. Outside temperature is 18 degrees centigrade.
Our crib for the week. Check out the view. Our apartment is right in front of a surf break called Banana Beach. We rented it through Airbnb. And it is exactly the way I imagine it.
Do you know where to...
There is Tajin's here in this town. Okay. It's a banana village.
Ali, who takes care of the apartment, is a local surfer and skateboarder. He offers to take us for lunch and we head to the village. I would have never been able to find this spot without Ali. Even inside the restaurant, it takes a guide to get to where we want to go.
You don't know what's tajin?
No.
This is tajin.
Oh, yeah.
This is chicken.
Oh, well.
Like 2 kilograms for a family.
Mm-hmm.
This is the... What did you
need again?
Morocco's Atlantic coast stretches for over 1,800 miles. I really want to explore this part of the country, and with new friends, my trip here becomes even more special. About 30 miles south of Agadir, Tifni is a fishing village with a really laid-back atmosphere.
Like the cool, this is hands down the coolest place we've been.
It's great that you can buy your fish right on the beach and then take it to a place to get it cooked. For just a small fee, we sit at a restaurant that looks more like someone's home. The beautiful Atlantic just outside.
Higher, man.
Yes.
Saha. In Moroccan, we say Saha.
When we drive back to Agadir, I get a chance to visit Ali's shop. Tamara Skateboards looks like a small business, but it's very active and sponsors skaters all over Morocco.
You want to stay here for the rest of your life?
Of course, man. Yeah. I love Morocco. You know, we have our parents. I can't. Where I go? I have my dad. He's a little. He's like 90 years. I'm not going to leave him, man. I love my family. I have my brothers here. I have friends, everyone. Surf, skates, sun, 300 days a year.
You get never boring here, you know. There is always something good to do. Surf and skate, you know.
If it's flat, you can skate. If there is waves, you can surf.
We're in our first Moroccan skate park, our first real Moroccan skate park. After spending some time in the area of Agadir, I explore part of N1, a highway that takes me to breathtaking views and beautiful spots on the shores of the Atlantic Ocean.
You see that mountain? It looks like coconut. Sweet!
In the 15th century, the Portuguese controlled the Atlantic coast of Morocco, and cities like Essaouira take you back in time. This is a popular tourist destination, but the city has a very laid-back feel, and its beautiful medina and fishing port are worth a visit. Walls and buildings made with red sandstone have given Marrakesh the nickname of the Red City. The Koutoubia Mosque has a typical local look, and it welcomes me into the old medina. Souk is the word for market, and this is where I start my trip. At the largest traditional Berber market in Morocco. How much? 50? Unique crafts are displayed throughout the busy alleys. And at times, with so much to see, I don't know which direction to look.
Oh, this way. Got me a warm little beanie, handmade, 40 dirhams, $4.
Bargaining in souks is expected. I'm shy at first, but when I find a store with things I want to buy, I have to play the game.
300.
You're a nice person. Treat well.
In the afternoon, I head to Jamia Al-Finat, a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Since 1985, the square has been described as a bridge between the past and the present, the place where Moroccan tradition encounters modernity. It's crazy, I have no idea where to go.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner. It's bloody marvelous.
Good.
I'm bloody Hell's Kitchen. Maybe later, alligator.
Yeah.
I like it.
Refreshing, it's really cold. One of the guys with the monkeys is trying to steal the photo off. So we're having escargot right now. Escargot, it's snails. We got a whole bowl of them. $9 for all these olives that I want to buy at the store.